بكت عيني بكت عيني بكت عيني على ذنبي وما لاقيت من كربي فيا ذلي ويا خجلي إذا ما قال لي ربي أما استحييته تعصيني ولا تخشى من العتب.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us an amazing incident that is going to occur on Judgment Day. And the title that is found in some of the classical books of tafsir is Khutbatu al-Shaytan, the khutbah of Shaytan. Shaytan is going to give a khutbah, a sermon. And the sermon of Shaytan will take place on Judgment Day, or some said, right after the judgment finishes and they have entered Jahannam. We need to ask ourselves, why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us of the sermon of Iblis? Why does the Quran have the sermon that Iblis is going to give to his followers? And the response is obvious, that before it happens, Allah Azza wa Jal is warning us to take heed. Benefit from it even before it takes place. Allah in His mercy told us the future. And He transcribed for us a sermon from the worst of the worst, so that we, inshaAllah ta'ala, will be protected from having to hear it directly from its source. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. All of them are going to be standing in front of Allah. فَقَالَ الضُّعَفَاءُ لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا. The weak, the majority of mankind that are simply followers, will say to the powerful, إِنَّا كُنَّا لَكُمْ تَبَعًا. We only followed you. You were the ones who told us to do all of these sins, to reject God, to do this and that. We followed you. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُغْنُونَ عَنَّا مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Can you now help us to be saved fully or partially from Allah's punishment? So the masses are going to look to their leaders. Look, you were our leaders. We put you in charge. And you were the ones who told us to reject Allah, to reject the prophets, to do this and that. And like we used to respect you and give you our wealth and our whatnot, now can you take our share as well, or at least a portion of our share of Allah's punishment? We all know the answer. They will say, قَالُوا لَوْ هَدَانَ اللَّهُ لَهْدَيْنَاكُمْ. It's not our fault. We weren't guided. If Allah didn't guide us, then, you know, it's not our fault. So they blame it on Allah. Even though in the end, all of mankind is equal when it comes to the intellect, when it comes to the fitrah, when it comes to recognizing truth from evil. It's not an excuse if a person says, reject God, you reject God. Allah gave you a mind as well. So they try to lay the blame on the leaders. The leaders say, it's not our fault. So then who else are they going to turn to? They turn to Shaytan. This is now the khutbah of Iblis. And they blame Iblis himself. It's all your fault. You did this. If you didn't misguide us, if we didn't follow you, then all of us, the leaders and the followers, wouldn't be where we are today. Our scholars mentioned that the people will surround Iblis and they will then be blaming Iblis. And so Iblis will stand up, yakhtub, give a khutbah. That's where we get the title khutbah to Iblis here. Pray that we never have to see it ourselves. They say that his followers bring him a mimbar and he will stand up on a mimbar. So all of the people of Jahannam will now be listening to the khutbah of Iblis. And Allah says in the Quran, وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ. Now when everything has been finished and the decrees have been passed, the people of Jannah go to Jannah, and the people of Jahannam being dragged to Jahannam. So they're seeing the reality of all take place. And they're blaming Iblis for all of this. وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ. Now, what lies can I say? What can I say now? إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعْدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ. You had two promises. You had the promise and the version of Allah, and then you had my promise. Now you see which promise is being enacted. You see the people of Jannah going to Jannah. You see the people of Jahannam going to Jahannam. You had these two promises. You could have chosen either one of them. I didn't hide Allah's promise from you. It was there. I gave you my promise. I'm not going to deny. وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ. I promised you. Follow me. You shall live a long life. Follow me. You will be happy. Follow me. You will enjoy. And Allah also promised you the promises of Allah in the Quran. Follow me, you shall enter Jannah. Follow me and live a righteous life. Follow me. The promises were there. So the two promises were in front of you. Now you and I both see. Inna Allaha wa'adakum wa'ad al-haq. The promise of Allah was true. And as for me, I lied. Iblis will then say, you are surrounding me. You're pointing your fingers at me. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't blame me. Blame yourselves. Why? وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. I didn't have any power over you. I did not have any force to force you to disobey Allah. I did not overtake you and then you became like zombies and robots. No. وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. I only had one art, and the art of deception, the art of lying. مَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. All that I did was I called you, told you to follow me. And Allah told you to follow Him. The two promises were there. You chose to follow me. I did not force you to follow me. In the end, He will say, مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخِكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِي. At this stage now, both of us are ending up in Jahannam. I cannot help you, nor can you help me. I have nothing I can do for you, neither can you do anything for me. What's the point of all this game blame? Inni kafartu bima ashraktumuni min qabl. I will do kufr with your shirk. That is what he is saying. What does this mean here? I will do kufr means I will reject, I will cut off ties. With your shirk means with your worship of me. Now, did people worship Iblis? The worship that they did was to obey him. The worship they did was to believe him. The worship that they did was to follow whatever Iblis wanted them to do. And that is a type of ubudiyah, that's a type of worship. In fact, the essence of worship is to follow, is to obey. Sami'na wa ata'na. And so Iblis calls their obedience to him worship. I am myself a kafir of your shirk. Means I don't acknowledge it. I had nothing to do with it. And I will not help you or benefit you or harm you. And I become neutral now. I cut myself off from anything to do with you. I'm going to have to now mind my own business in Jahannam. And you're going to have to mind your own. Verily the zalimeen, verily the sinners are now all going to face a painful torment.
فَيَا ذُلِّي وَيَا خَجَلِي إذا ما قال لي ربي أما استحييته تعصيني ولا تخشى من العتب وتخفي الذنب عن خلقي وتأبى في الهوى قربي فتب مما جنيت عسى تعود إلى رضا الرب تعود إلى رضا الرب.